This is probably one of the most important videos I have on my channel. What's popping, people? It's your boy, the Beast of Ecom, and I am back with another video dropping nothing, but you already know, value bombs. So this weekend has been absolutely crazy and busy as hell with, of course, Black Friday and, you know, the sales over this weekend. And, of course, it's Cyber Monday today at the time of recording this video. So, obviously, of course, I hope you are all sending those emails, crushing it today. And I hope you all had a fantastic Black Friday and weekend sales as well. Congratulations to those who did get in on the Black Friday sale for EconBeast 2.0. There is a sale on only for 24 hours today, okay, on the course. So if you are interested in getting in at a discounted rate, then just click the link down below. It's only for 24 hours, but let's put that to a side for 1 second. So today's video is probably one of the most important videos that I have on my channel. Now, you may be asking why. Now, I get tons of different messages all of the time about ad accounts being banned, and you know, I've been running adverts but I got banned, or every time I scale I get banned, when I open a new account I get banned. What should I do? So I decided to put out this video today to explain some of the things, you know, prevention wise you need to be doing to make sure that your account doesn't get banned. And then, of course, some of the things that you can do if your ad account has been banned at this moment in time, or if you've just been recently banned, what are the certain different steps you need to be doing to try and get your ad accounts or business manager back up and running so you can start spending money on Facebook. Of course, if you get some value from this video, which I can pretty much guarantee that you will, make sure you like, comment, and of course, smash that subscribe button, and be sure to hit the notification bell as well so you stay up to date with all of my latest content. Plus, I will do a giveaway on this video because I haven't done one in quite some time. So if you want to be in with a chance to win $20 for 100% free, I'll just send it to you via PayPal. Then drop a comment down below with the value that you got from this video, and of course, hashtag value bombs as well. So drop a comment along with hashtag value bombs and I'll pick someone at total random. So let's quickly talk in, let's jump straight into the computer and start learning how you can get back up and running with your ad accounts. Right, so let's get straight into this one. And like I said, this is probably one of the most important videos that I have put out, because if you have had an ad account banned before, then this is gonna help you out massively in terms of trying to get you back into the game. You may already be back into the game, and kind of to help, you know, not get you banned again. So this is kind of gonna, this video is kind of gonna be twofold. So the first part we need to talk about is prevention, because of course prevention is much better than cure. So how to actually prevent your ad account getting banned in the first place, so that you don't have to deal with all the hassle, the stress, and the, you know, the headaches and those sorts of things. And then some of the things I'm going to talk about a bit later is some of the things that you can do if you're currently banned right about now. So let's get straight onto it. Again, you're going to get loads of value out of this one, and make sure you do stay to the end and watch absolutely all of it. So first things first is prevention. So let me just show you what you need to be doing. Is the first things first is do not sell black hat stuff. So what do I mean by kind of black hat stuff? Well, first and foremost, you don't want to be selling any sort of copyrighted products. You know, all the Harry Potter stuff, the Game of Thrones stuff, you know, Lord of the Rings or Fortnite or any sort of those sorts of things. Just completely avoid selling those things, okay? They are pretty much a surefire way to get your ad account banned. So try to avoid all of those. Now, secondly is the China-based beauty skincare products. Now, I've seen tons of different adverts out there for these sorts of products. I try to avoid these sorts of products at kind of all costs. But they are out there, and to be honest, I don't understand how some of these ad accounts are actually getting these adverts approved. I've been told that some people may have, you know, people on the inside of Facebook or getting things ad accounts whitelisted. I have no idea, but you know, you don't want to be doing and selling these sorts of products, because they are one of the most, you know, they're the highly sort of products that are going to get your ad account banned and flagged. So the China-based ones that prevent stuff like skin stretching, skin marks, and, you know, acne creams, and, you know, these sorts of things that are based in China, okay? And, you know, you see these sorts of videos on there of them making wild claims and stuff like that can clear up, you know, different sorts of skin problems and skin issues. Try to avoid selling those products, okay? Even if you do find something that is out there that is selling well, you know, and avoid, of course, before and after pictures as well. So they're the type of products that I try to avoid, that you need to pretty much avoid at all costs. And of course, these skincare products, you know, if they're based in China, God knows what sort of ingredients are in there. So if any sort of consumer has an allergic reaction or anything to like that, you know, you don't really want to have a lawsuit on your hands whatsoever. Okay, so they're the first thing you need to be not doing, is not selling these black hatted products. Now, try not to get too many disapproved ads. Now, Facebook takes these things into account. Now, if you are getting loads of disapproved ads, then you will end up in what's called manual review. Now, some of you guys may have been in manual review as well. And being in manual review is likely to lead to, you know, things taking a long time to get approved. So you put in adverts, you're getting things out there and it's taking like 24 hours before your adverts actually start spending. Your ad account may have been placed inside of manual review, okay? So that's why things get take a lot longer to get approved. And of course, Facebook are going to be going over your adverts in a lot more detail and a lot more scrutiny. So of course, in that case, you need to be making sure that your adverts are, of course, above board. Now, if they are going over things in a lot more detail in your ad account, then of course, you've got a more higher chance of getting your ad account banned, or your business manager being banned as well. So, you know, try not to get as many things disapproved, your adverts being disapproved. If you're getting tons of different things disapproved, then you really want to be wary of being placed inside manual review. Now, it's all well and good saying don't get too many disapproved ads, but what sort of things can you do to make sure that your ad account, your adverts, sorry, are being approved? So here are some things to avoid getting your adverts disapproved. Now, first thing is, do not call your audience out directly. Facebook kind of don't really like this. So, you know, things like avoid calling them out based on their characteristics, their age, or their certain profile. So, for example, there, you know, you don't really want to kind of put this in your ad copy whatsoever. So, you know, are you a mom? Or do you suffer with acne, or do you suffer with X, whatever X may be? Okay, so you don't want to be calling them out directly, because that is one way that Facebook don't like to, it's called profanity. You don't really want to base them on any sort of their age, race, sex, or anything like that. Don't call them out in your ad copy whatsoever. Now, I found that obviously hobbies and ownership seem to be okay. Of course, not houses. So you don't want to say, are you a homeowner? Because Facebook go a bit crazy when it comes to, you know, selling houses and real estate and those sorts of things. But stuff like, you know, do you own a dog, or do you enjoy tennis? So calling them out in that way seems to kind of be above board, and I haven't really had any problems whatsoever with calling people out on that front. But when it comes down to characteristics, such as being a mom, a grandparent, or do you suffer from X, or are you, you know, those sorts of things, and the characteristics and their profanity filter, then, you know, you don't really want to call them out in that way. Now, one thing you can do is, that's supposed to say frame things differently. So, you know, such as saying, are you a mum? You could say, mums are going absolutely crazy for this, you know, whatever this may be, or whatever your products may be. You've just got to be really clever with your words and think about how you're putting it, how your ad copy is coming across, and you're not being as direct. Okay. So that is one thing that I found out personally from getting adverts disapproved myself, and when I make those changes and frame things a little bit differently, then they seem to get approved, rather than just calling people out directly and getting caught in the Facebook profanity filter. So another thing is, of course, you should already kind of know this one, but avoid using engagement bait. And Facebook, you know, came out and stated this, you know, they're against kind of engagement bait. Some people still use them on adverts, I do see it, but I generally try to avoid it at all costs, just to stay above board, because I don't want any ad accounts banned. So don't use words like, you know, in your ad copy, you know, tag someone who would like this, or share this with friends, you know, comment below someone who should buy this for you. Now, previously, a few years ago, before Facebook said it was okay Facebook allowed you to kind of do these things, and it's called engagement bait, to try and get people to like, comment, share, and all those sorts of things on your advert, which used to work fantastically, actually. But Facebook then came out and said they don't like engagement bait, so you kind of have to use things a little bit different, and you can't blatantly just say, you know, tag X and stuff like that. So again, you don't want to avoid using engagement bait. So the next thing you need to do, or not to do essentially, is avoid using negative connotation or sentiment words. Now, this is something that has been stated by Sam Ovens, which he came out with. And basically, it's believed that Facebook has a built-in system that monitors the sentiment of words. Now, if you don't know what sentiment means or connotation, basically, it's like the feeling that that is assumed with a certain word. So, for example, you know, words like sick, tired, hard, suffer, unhappy, they generally have a negative connotation to them. So when you say those words, people generally think negative of it. It generally kind of has a negative feeling associated to those words. So being suffering, unhappy, hard, tired, sick, and stuff like that. So you want to try and avoid those sorts of words. Try to use happier words instead, that have a positive sentiment. So happy, you know, loving, love, this is absolutely amazing, this is a great product, this is fantastic, this is wonderful. So you know, try and avoid using the bad words. And try thinking and using instead of saying, are you sick, tired of X, or are you sick and tired of whatever it may be, say, you know, you can change things around and say, you know, this is an absolutely fantastic, amazing product, whatever it may be, and then go into obviously your ad copy and stuff like that. So try frame things a little bit different. Now, moving on, is you need to warm up your ad account first, and a lot of people don't do this, okay? Just run a really cheap PPE, paid post engagement campaign, very low cost, and just start to get your ad creatives approved and up and running in the first place. That's the main goal, is to get your ad creatives approved. Because of course, if you've got an aged account now, if I put something live, it pretty much gets approved within a matter of, you know, 10 minutes or so, if that, and start spending. Whereas if you've got a newer account, when you put something live, it doesn't just come live in 10 minutes, because Facebook take into account your ad account age, history, and all those sorts of things. So if you are opening up a new account, just run a low paper engagement cost campaign to start with, and just focus on getting your ad creatives approved. Then, of course, what you can do is just pay off your bill early and show Facebook that you are there to pay to play. That's the most important thing, that you are paying, and you know, you are making payments to Facebook, because, of course, it's money in their pocket. They obviously, of course, like that. Don't jump straight into a new ad account with a website conversion campaign with like 10 ad sets, 2 creatives, you know, and all this sort of jazz, because if you get disapproved, then you've got tons of different ads there, all disapproved, which Facebook can, of course, flag. So start really slow, warm up an ad account to start with, and then, of course, once you're paying money and stuff like that, then start to venture into your website conversion campaigns. Now, finally, before we move on to cure, always have backups of backups, and I always preach this no matter what. You always have to back up the backup, then back up the backup even more. Okay, so what you need to be doing is add as many people as possible to your business manager. Now, I don't care if they're friends, their family, or whatever it may be, they're basically just silent people who they don't have to know anything about adverts whatsoever. They're just there to, just in case you get banned personally. Okay, if your Facebook profile gets banned personally or anything like that, then you can still log in and, of course, access your adverts. Of course, you want to create backup ad accounts, but of course, you have to be spending money on them now, because Facebook changed the rules whereby you can't just have tons of different ad accounts just sitting there spending no money whatsoever. They'll disable them if you aren't spending any money in, I think it's 60 days. So 60 or 90 days, I can't remember what it is off the top of my head. So what you can do, of course, is open up another ad account and just run a really low spend, $1 a day, $2 a day, paper engagement post to something, to your website. You can do that just to keep it alive, but make sure you've got backups. Then of course you want to create another business manager as well, okay, so that you've got two. And of course you want to back up pixels on your site that you can do through various apps, Pixel Perfect or Trackify, so that you've got two pixels on your website. So if one ad account that is tied to does get banned, you've got another account still collecting data and stuff like that. So there are sorts of things for prevention. Now let's talk about cure if you've currently been banned or recently been banned. So now, if your ad account has just been banned, if you just had your ad account been banned, okay? Now, this is, first thing you want to do, of course, is just reach out to your Facebook rep. If you've got one, if you've been spending X amount of money, you may have a Facebook rep. If you haven't, then of course, you can use the chat feature that they've now got to reach out to someone and they can get you via email and stuff like that. So try to understand why you were actually disabled in the first place, because of course, that's gonna help you massively in not doing the exact same thing. Most of the time, it's just to violations of the policies, and you know they generally always use that as one, so violation of policies, blah, 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 blah. You can, of course, is recommended to check out the Facebook advertising policies, and you may have, if you go through that, you may have breached something, but check that. Now, of course, if it is just that, then you can just use another ad account in your business manager, okay? Hopefully, you've created more that are backups. So if you have, then you can just always just use another one. This is, of course, if your ad account has been banned. Now, if your business manager has been banned, okay, this is a little bit more major. So if your ad account, if your business manager has been banned, then you will need to pretty much need new everything to get up and running. Okay, so you're going to need a new bank card, you're going to need a new profile, you're going to need a new email address, you're going to need a new business manager, new ad accounts as well. So pretty much everything new. Now, of course, do not share any of the data from your old account whatsoever. So, you know, your lookalike audiences, your pixels, your custom audiences, do not share anything with your new business manager whatsoever. Now, it could be that you've got a possible IP ban. And some people say that every time I create something new, it just gets disabled off the bat. You may need to have a VPN to access Facebook so it changes your IP address, because Facebook, sometimes they say that they can IP ban you, which has been floating around. So if that is the case, get a VPN set up. Then, of course, what you want to do is clear all cookies as well. You can uninstall and then reinstall a new Chrome browser so everything is brand new and fresh. Basically, what I'm trying to say is you need to start 100% over again. Yes, it is a pain in the backside, but of course, if you want to pay to play to get up and running and your business manager has been banned, then you're going to need absolutely new everything, and try not to cross anything from your old account into your new account. So hopefully everything in this video has helped you out. Remember, focus on prevention. And of course, last case scenario, if you have been banned, then rewatch this video and go through the things in the cure section. So hopefully this video has helped you out. As usual, I hope you got some value from this video. If you did, make sure, of course, you like, comment, and make sure you smash that subscribe button. And be sure to, of course, to hit the notification bell as well, become a part of the notification gang and stay up to date with all of my latest content. Now, if you've been banned and successfully got your ad account back, then drop a comment down below and let other people know what you did to get your ad account back, because I can pretty much guarantee there's going to be tons of people in the exact same position. Okay, so sharing value is going to help everyone out as well. So drop a comment down below if you were in that position before. Hit me up on Instagram, drop me a like, drop me a DM, drop me a follow, and we can try and connect on there. And make sure, of course, you are in the free Facebook mastermind. The link for that will be down below. And of course, Econ Beast 2.0 is currently on Cyber Monday sale. It's only for 24 hours. So if you do want to get in, congratulations to everyone who already has taken advantage. Then again, click the link down below. It's only for 24 hours. Okay. And of course, the free Facebook Mastermind group, that's 100% free all of the time. Okay. So that is it for this video. I'll be back with another one dropping nothing, but you already know, value bombs. If you got some value, make sure you drop a comment and of course a thumbs up. And I'll be back with another one. So take care and I'll see you later.